Am I the asshole for not being sorry that I didn't believe my daughter's knee was hurting? I have a 15-year-old daughter and my husband is currently out of town. I have a lot of projects that need to be done in my yard and I really needed her help. On Friday, she told me her knee was hurting after a run and she was limping. I told her, it's funny how your body always seems to malfunction when I need your help. You can just stay in bed all day if you want, because it's true. She has a history of faking in order to get out of things she doesn't want to do. She hasn't done it much since she was around 9, but I still have trouble trusting her when she says something is wrong. She said she helped me and I told her we could take her to the ER if her knee still hurt by the time the yard work was done. We worked the whole weekend and she complained a lot, but I was almost certain that she would magically be better by the end of the weekend. This morning though, she said her knee was hurting badly and she could hardly walk. I took her to the ER and it turns out she had sprained her knee. I told her to tell them that it only started hurting today, but she told them the truth and I was questioned. Fortunately, nothing bad happened, but they said it's definitely going to take longer to recover. I decided to keep her home from school today because I don't necessarily want her telling people that I had her doing work while her knee hurt. She has a tendency to exaggerate. I feel slightly guilty, but I said it wouldn't have happened if she didn't have a history of lying. She's pissed and upset that I didn't trust her.
Story time about when I lost my virginity to a water slide. So, do you guys know those water slides that you stand in and then they suddenly drop you straight down onto the water slide? If not, look them up on YouTube. There's nothing like them. Ah, yes. The sweet memories of my first time on one of these. I feel that my mental and emotional scars have healed enough to tell this gem. At the time, my girlfriend, now fiance, worked as a photographer for one of those resorts with the indoor and outdoor water parks. One of her perks was that her and a family member or friend could get into the water park for free. So one hot summer day she had off, we both decided it'd be fun to go there and cool down for the day. While we were there, I discovered one of their most thrilling looking water slides. Basically, you stand in this tube and then the slide operator presses a button and the slide drops you straight down like 90 feet before you actually start going down the water slide. Me, being a thrill seeker, of course, had to try it. So I made a great climb up to the top of the slide, stood in line, and finally it was my turn. Once I got in the tube, the operator told me to keep my legs crossed. Now I'm a pretty big heavy guy, so I was like, that's uncomfortable as fuck, I'm not doing that. So there I was, standing in the tube, having a panic attack from anticipation, with my legs not crossed. The operator finally presses the button and the bottom opens and I fall straight down the water slide. Very quickly, I realize why they have you cross your legs. Water shot so far up my ass, so fast, I swear I tasted it in my mouth. My body raced down that slide as I questioned every life choice I had ever made. Once I made it down to the bottom, I sat there for a moment, absolutely violated. I felt like someone in an old episode of Law & Order, Special Victims Unit. I built up the courage to finally stand up, and all I could feel was a nice warm stream of water mixed with shit, and maybe a little bit of blood shoot out of my ass faster than a steamboat geyser at Yellowstone National Park. I quickly got off the slide and ran to the bathroom, with a trail of shitty water tailing me as the slide operator stared in awe. They had to shut down the slide for the rest of the day, but man was my asshole clean after that.
My 22 female boyfriend, 25 male, is hiding all of my stuff, and I have no idea why. My boyfriend of 5 months just moved in with me 3 weeks ago. He had some problems with his apartment, damp walls, and it has to be renovated. As my roommate is currently spending some time abroad, I told him it would be okay if he stayed at my place for 4 to 6 weeks. He'll be able to move back to his own apartment by that time. So now we've been living together for 3 weeks, and things started out great. Jealousy had been a bit of a problem between us because we often go out separately, probably once a week, but coming home to the same apartment helped him get over that. But there has been one new problem. Now, this may seem petty at first, but I'm really at my wit's end with this one. Ever since he moved in with me, things started disappearing and then reappearing one day later in the same place they were missing from. I'm talking about documents, small household items, and food. And it's not like losing keys and then finding them again somewhere. I specifically look for something in a certain place where it isn't, but it's there the next day. For example, I like to take a chocolate bar with me to work in the morning, and for that, I normally have a pack of chocolate bars at home. Shortly after he moved in with me, I woke up to find all the chocolate was gone. I asked him about it. He said he didn't know anything about it. I came home just to find the chocolate bars are in the cupboard again. I ask him. He says he doesn't know anything about it. Quote, maybe you just didn't see them in the morning. We're talking about a large pack with about 12 chocolate bars. How can I not see that? At first, I thought it was maybe some kind of strange humor, but he seems angry when I bring it up. And it's starting to really piss me off because sometimes it's been items belonging to one of my friends that I wanted to give back to them and then couldn't, or it was certain documents I needed for a certain day. Now I have absolutely no idea what this is about. I am not crazy. I just don't understand at all. He gets really angry when I talk about it, saying I'm making this up just to, quote, cause drama. Why should I? I have no idea what's going on. Any ideas?
Am I the a-hole for telling my mom I am successful despite her? Not thanks to her parenting? For context, I-31 male have a brother, Paul 33 male, who is a screw-up. He's a felon, breaking into people's homes to steal valuables. And in general, Paul has no work ethic, no drive to improve, no moral compass. He's rude, cruel, and uneducated. I, on the other hand, have a PhD from my country's top university, and I started my own company, which is now employing 5 people full-time plus myself and my significant other. Our lives, our mother, Mary, 63 years old, favored Paul strongly. The greasy wheels get the grease principle. I could bring home perfect grades, and Paul all failing grades besides one barely passing grade, and Mom would fall over herself congratulating Paul and buying him a new iPod. Well, my grades barely get me a nod of acknowledgement. I worked jobs after school ended summer, only for my salaries to be stolen by Paul to buy weed, and Mom always gave him a pass. Our mother is a very warm woman, and I can tell that she wanted to celebrate even the tiniest achievement of Paul's to encourage him. And she didn't have the heart to punish slash discipline either me or my brother. But in the end, it screwed over both Paul and me. Paul was taught that Mom will always bail him out, and that stealing is consequence-free, until the actual police was involved and not just our Mom. I have been slowly unraveling with my therapist all the ways in which being essentially wallpaper my whole childhood led me to having attachment issues, intense anxiety, abysmally low self-worth, and an unhealthy habit to both bury myself in work and always feel like a failure no matter how much I accomplish. Then Mom called me today to invite me to a big party to celebrate Paul getting a job. It's unskilled, in retail. By now, I fully expect Paul to be fired, or just decide to stop showing up less than 1 week in. I told Mom no, because we live in different cities, it is not worth celebrating that mediocrity. It led to a heated conversation, and eventually her telling me that I need to give back because I'm prosperous. I shot back that I work to earn all I have, and with a mother like her, it was an uphill battle. She told me she always supported me, and I told her what I typed above, and hung up angry. She texted me, "I'm sorry you feel that way, and that I'm still welcome to Paul's party." I've been pacing and restless. Was I an a-hole? Am I the a-hole for telling my 24 male twin sister 24 female that she no longer has a brother? So I had a fiancé 24 female and I just knew she was the woman I'd spend my life with. She was great in every way. Her and my sister clicked greatly and they became best friends, which was huge for me because my sister and I were best friends as well. So I'd go on double dates with her and her now husband. I found out my fiancé was cheating on me and blew up on her. She cried and said the usual stuff, but I was destroyed and called off our engagement and broke up with her. She ended up getting in a relationship with her affair partner, which stands to this day. Afterwards, before I blocked my ex and everything as I simply forgot, I saw her post on Facebook a picture of her new boyfriend happily hanging out with my sister and her then fiancé. I got angry at my sister and told her I thought it was wrong for her to do that. I know that she's a grown woman, but I thought that she would be mad at her too, especially since we are so close. I mean, we are twins. She tried to explain to me that she loves me more than anyone, but that she cherishes her friendship with my ex and didn't want to let either of us go. I ignored her after that and she called me. We went back and forth, her trying to plead with me, and me angrily refusing to see her point of view. I then told her, "Have fun with your new friendship. Don't contact me again. I'm done with you." And then blocked her and my ex and everything. Since then, I moved from our old apartment and have gotten a new one, and changed my number. My father and a few trusted friends have this info and have been instructed not to give it to my sister. My father had been telling me that my sister had been distraught and wanting to talk to me, but I was pretty adamant that I didn't want to. He obliged. Then she called me on a new number and told me she was getting married, and that she would love for me to be there. I was ecstatic at first, but then I remembered my ex had asked if she and her new boyfriend would be there, to which she replied that she was going to be a bridesmaid and that the boyfriend would be there. I then told her that as of now, we are both only children. A little harsh, but I was angry. I hung up the phone and blocked the number. They are married now, but my dad tells me that she is visibly distressed and that he is afraid it will take a toll on her marriage. I don't want this to happen, but I am in no way over any of this. I still feel betrayed twice. I don't really want to see her at all. My biggest thing is that when she was cheated on by her college boyfriend, who I became friends with, I scolded him and comforted her. But when I get heartbroken by my fiancé and soon-to-be wife, she feels like it's okay to mingle with her and guide and help her break herself. As if I don't matter. Although I love her to death, I feel a lot of hatred towards her right now. So,